Good morning. It's not even good morning now, is it? It's good afternoon. I'm in my local cigar store, and I did just want to show you their humidor because it is amazing, and I do use them quite often, just because. Look at that. That is amazing. Now, I quickly just wanted to talk about how do I choose a cigar personally, because you may look at this and go, yeah, wow, a Partagas. What's that? Dunno. It's a cigar. But there's a real easy way of telling about different cigars, and that is literally just look at them. Yeah, you just got to have a keen eye. Now, where should I start? I'm going to start off with the tubos. Which are basically these little tubes that the cigars come in, like that. Wow. And so this whole row is just tubos, but when you look at it, so this is Montecristo. You open it up, have a look. You want have a look at it. You want to check it out. You want to make sure no cracks. There's no blemishes, there's no spots. You just want to make sure it looks all right. I'm going to put this one back. Now, when you look at these, obviously you want to look at the price, because price is a very key factor in this, especially in the UK, because we've got the highest, or one of the highest, prices for tobacco. One of the highest taxes. So, as you can see, where is it? The H Upman Magnum 54. That's a classic. Maybe not that close. Jesus.
I forgot his fish eye.
So this one currently is £40 in here, or just under £40. And this is how it looks. This one is a Cuban, so everything with Cuba is normally much more expensive here because it comes through Hunter and Frankel. So that's one thing to consider. If it comes from Havana or Cuba, it's going to be more expensive and it's going to be very high priced. Although I will say, Guantanameras, Cubans as well, but they're only about tenner, so they match Nicaraguan or Honduran tobaccos. Now, as we go down, you'll see more of these cigars which are not covered in cellophane. Mainly, I think this is just because the humidifier is working constantly in here and it's quite small. So I probably wouldn't have cellophane on for something this small, personally. But it looks nice. Cellophane, normally, if you're going for ones with cellophane, it's going to be ones that are naturally non-Cuban. So nearly all Cubans you will get don't have cellophane on. Right, the next part that I think is very important is ring gauge and size. Because ring gauge really tells you so much about a cigar. So as you can see, I'm going back to the Magnum 54. This is a 54 ring gauge. So if it's, it's bigger than that one, obviously, because that's a 52. But be the next one up. So normally with larger ring gauges, they're more light because obviously you're getting so much more through a big hole like that compared to a tiny one. So when you go for tinier ones, they're normally more compact and they're more tougher strains of tobacco. So it'd be more, what's the word? Stronger strains of tobacco. So, as we can see on this one, the Paul Laranja, very skinny and very long. So this would easily be about a 30, 32, maybe even 34 ring gauge. So this one would be very strong, especially because it's very long as well. I'm trying to think of the name of it, because it is a certain length and type that makes it. It's a special given name. I'll put it right under me because I'm not remembering it. But these type of cigars, very strong because you don't get a lot through it. So you go, and it's almost one puff and you've done like that much. Yeah, it's like a cigarette. It's the best way of putting it. It's like a really strong cigarette. So when you puff that in, it's going to be strong and it's going to be really, really flavourful tobacco compared to something like this, which is going to be light. It's going to be almost airy when you smoke it. You know, you're going to have lots of more lighter notes on the tongue. Now, when it comes to length as well, normally a longer cigar ends up being a bit stronger. No, longer cigars normally a bit lighter, but obviously in the case of these Paul Laranjas, they're going to be stronger instead. So, try to see if I can find a long fat one.
A chub.
Yeah, I'll use this one for example.
That's a big
the
one.
Zeno Nicaragua. These are good. I like them quite a lot. So this would probably be one of my go-tos. I think it's very light compared to it. And for the length, you're going to get a very light palate on it. Because if it's too long and it's very strong, you're just going to go really sick. You know, you're just going to be... Because genuinely, my first time smoking a cigar, I took it back and I was like, Jesus, this is fucking strong. So really do remember to pace yourself when you're smoking some of these. That's very important. Now, up here, they've put all these packs. So these, I would say, are... They've obviously got Puritos as a name. That is their name, proper name. But to me, you're basically just smoking a fag, which, very unpopular opinion about me. I don't mind them, but really, you are basically just smoking a fag. I probably shouldn't say fag, should I? That's a bit offensive. Cigarette. So you're basically smoking a cigarette. And to me, I prefer much more longer smoke like that, because these are Puritos. Also under clubs. Clubs are about just under the same size. They'll be just as long. So these ones, a good way of experiencing what this tobacco is like. So originally I went for some Romeo Juliet Puritos, and that uses that Cuban tobacco, but it uses much more less, so it's much cheaper. 5 over £12, it's about £2 each, isn't it? So it's much more easier going, and you really get a flavour for it. Same with these ones, tiny. I don't see the point. You're better off just trying a club, or a club or a Purito, which are practically almost the size of a cigar at that point. Now, these are where I have a real divided attention. These are tins. Now, all these tins are sealed. Oh, this one's not. I'll put that back. They're going to watch that. Oh, this one's not sealed either. Oh, I'll show you then. Because if it's open, I'll show you. So these are tins, basically. You get five, six, maybe sometimes four. And basically, there are a certain size that they do. For some reason, and I don't agree with this, they're more expensive. And I think it's just a tin. But personally, I don't think they're worth it. They're nice, you get a nice tin, they're collectible, but to me, you're better off just getting a proper cigar instead of, something like a tin. Because you get five, but £85 for five works out over, God knows, a lot. Yeah, it happens.
Like more than £20, I swear, for five.
Yeah, well, they did have the Romeo and Juliet ones here, which were much more. I'm talking about probably £100.
I mean, like for that packet, I think it's £20 per.
Yeah, it works out roughly around £20.
Yeah.
£20 each. But if you buy them outside the UK, like I'm saying, although do support your local tobacconist, like I do, because I do like buying here, just remember you're better off buying cigars outside the UK, because you're going to save so much more. But please, please do support these people. They need to make a living. It's quality. They've got the EMS mark, so it means they're proper English market selection. You ain't getting ripped off. Plus, if you've got blocked cigar, you know, you've got a problem with your cigar. Hey, Hunter Frankel, my cigar's wrong. Sorry, we'll give you a new one.
Yeah.
They do that. Trust me, they do that. Plus, if you can prove it, that it's an EMS, you know, all congrats to you, because they'll easily give you one. So it's very important to know. If you buy them here, and if it's messed up, you get a refund on it. Especially if it's a box. Please, if you say to them, my whole box is plugged, send you a whole box. That is a real good deal. Now, what else? Shades of colour of tobacco. This is very, very important, because this is an underground. It is an underground. Yeah, Drew Estate underground. I'm not going metal. If you look at that. Right, so we just quickly interrupted. No problem with that. Obviously, I am taking up most of the humidor. We both are.
Yeah.
So, quickly just talk about colour. Colour is very important when it comes down to this. This underground, Drew Estate underground, I don't know what the rest of the name is. All decked out Robusto. That's too long a name, just call it underground. Yeah, it's simple. This one's a very dark wrapper. Normally, that means it's gonna be a very, very strong tobacco. But I should say Camachos, you'll get very light skin ones, and they're gonna be very, very pungent. I mean, I'm talking, you're gonna smoke it, you go, oh Jesus, this is stronger than I thought. That's gonna happen. You will have some cigars like that, and you're also gonna find ones like this, which is also, I just picked up this already. But there's some cigars which will be this color, and it's gonna be much more lighter, much more flavorful and light, airy, like I said. So it happens. Now lastly, this is where I despise every one of you who buy this. I only buy these when I'm making a joke. See, you can tell no one buys them because they've got a whole fucking box full. Also, I should say, this does annoy me just slightly, because these are flavoured and they're right next to non-flavoured cigars. Which, they are separated by a border, you see, so I'm not too mad, but they are vanilla, sweet flavoured. This despises me. I despise this. You're going to smoke tobacco, why would you go for one that's flavoured? Doesn't make sense to me.
What flavour is it?
Well, it's a blondie, so it's more like vanilla, sweet notes. But why would you choose one when you've got all this great tobacco that actually, it's natural tobacco and it has a taste? This one, they put flavourings in. Why would you put flavourings in tobacco? Smoke a vape. If you're going to go for bubblegum, go for bubblegum vape. Don't go for bubblegum cigars. No. This is natural. That's not.
How much did that cost as well?
This one's £11.50. Although if you do buy them out of the UK, they're about like a fiver. Or even less, like £3 each. So and normally they're a box of 50. And then you could buy a box of 50 but for about £100. Surprisingly enough. But yeah. Personally, I don't go for them. I think they're terrible. I think most of them have this real artificially flavour, and it's over the top compared to something natural where you get only slight hints and notes. I didn't go over price, did I, properly?
What do you mean price?
Like £40 here, £40 there. So, with price. Very quick note, because I didn't properly go over this. Obviously, some cigars are more expensive. Normally, that's because they're live and limited edition. You know, they've got certain places make them limited edition as well, or it's a brand. So, Havana cigars, normally mostly expensive because, you know, Cuban tobacco right now is also going through a crisis where they've only got about, I kid you not, I read this in an article. They have, this couple years, they have had less tobacco than when they originally started producing tobacco. They had more tobacco when they started than when they,
currently.
Yeah, currently. So cigars for all Cubans will be going up exponentially, because they don't know what they're really doing, really. Because the ground is weathered, they're getting constant tornadoes with the heat rising. It's a real pain. But if you're going for something else, don't always go for Cubas, mix it up. It's important. Personally, today I picked up a Montecristo wide Edmundo. I've currently got ones on me that I've brought from home. My Tatuaje, it's just, I don't even know the flavour. This came in my advent calendar. So, yeah, happens. But make sure you go for different things. Don't always smoke these. Mix it up. This is most important to me. Mix it up. £40 on a cigar, you can buy one of these, or you can buy a San Cristobal, and then you can buy two blondies. Don't go for the blondies, obviously. You could buy two. And for some of these, Davidoff's here, £50. £50 a tin. Only five petit panettones. Yeah. A tin of these, five of them, £10 each. But personally, they're tiny. If you're going to smoke Davidoff, go for a big Davidoff because they're better priced, personally. Although these are pretty good short smokes, so don't quote me on that. They're pretty good short smokes. And now, one part I do love. Backwoods.
Backwoods.
Now, personally, backwoods to me are just like the weed cigars. You cut them open. Thanks. you cut them open and you basically sprinkle a bit of the hash in, roll it back up. Yeah, to me, they're not bad because they do taste more natural than acid. Acid tastes like acid. Yeah, be warned. To me, I think these are a bit better, but at the same time, they can be still sickly sweet.
Mostly used for just blunts.
Yeah, literally, mostly used for blunts. So if you've ever seen smoking this, you might be seen as a weed smoker. There you go. Do you want to pass me a tin down there? The Romeo and Julietas.
Do this one.
Next one over. Yes. Or is that Horace de Monterey? Oh, it is a Horace de Monterey. Okay, five Souvenir Deluxe. This one is... Is it open? It is open. Or is it? I'm debating on... Oh, it is. Okay.
It's open.
So, yeah. 10 and 5. I don't understand these. They're good for souvenir tins, but really... They are their own flavour. They are their own cigar type of flavour. You're not going to find these sold anywhere else. They're only going to be sold in tins. So if you do want to buy these, you're going to have to buy them in tins. But it's real mix with some of these, because if you don't age them well, they just taste naff. You know, you feel real bland. I still have to check now. Oh, sorry, is that there? It is a tiny humidor. But please remember, support your local cigar shop. Support local, buy local, do whatever you want. You know, just go there, even if you just turn up and buy one, it's helping them out because they buy more and now you end up with a shelf like this. I heard that. I'm calling you out quick. He farted, so that's
okay,
why we can't.
Okay, what?
So this one clearly states Maduro, even though it doesn't look as dark as a wrapper compared to the Undercrown. How weird. You get that a lot with cigars. You know, some places say, you know, that one's Maduro. When you look at it, someone else will say, oh, that's just a normal one. That's quite light for us. So as well as that, this one's special because it's square. It's square, look at that. These, basically, all they do is, when they press them, they have special cigar presses. That's why they're all round normally. This one, it's just square. Yeah, it doesn't really change much on how you smoke it, because sometimes you do end up with a better smoke because it's square, because it ends up burning somewhat better. But at the end, it's real mix and match. Like a Camemberger, I've never tried a Camemberger, I should say, but I have tried other cigars, like Oliver Series G. That one was square, that was a square pyramidas. That's not bad, and that ended up with a very good, burn. So yeah, just go with your instinct, really. Start cheap, because when you start cheap, you actually get a feel for if you like it or not. If you go, I'm going to buy the most expensive cigar, you're going to have your life ruined because you don't know what you're tasting for, you don't know what you're looking for, it will get ruined. Alright, so I think we're near the end because, yeah, even you're nodding, we have been in here for such a long time that people are looking around, looking at us filming. And I've already placed my orders, so I'm going to show you a picture at the end of what I got. Why not? Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and show your support. You know, go to your local cigar shop, like I've just said multiple times. You have buy something like I do here, and heck, you want, check this one out in Bury St Edmunds, because it's a pretty good one. I like the owner, me and him get along. Heck, I even bought a fucking mince pies. yeah, great selection here, great selection most places. You're not going to get find it everywhere. This one, I think, is pretty lucky. So, yeah, one final look around. And I'd just like to say goodbye.